Thank you. Using the message of Which is interesting specific for each Thank you. Have these graphs, and if we have the biomarker and the reduction of the EM and the visual histology and the OCT and the power bar and the temperature, we consider that we have the license to do something in this patient. Now it is interesting because that's the lesion, and during the course we decide to stent this lesion. And I can tell you there was a kind of Romani in the audience. Said it was the first reaction, what you're doing is crazy. But I've been talking about this patient in more detail and more quietly with her. And when you review some of these arguments, I think that we have some technology who allows you to go ahead. And it will be very painful if this patient, which is very well known from us, from multiple interventions, die suddenly or get an important myocardial infarct. So yes, we stent immediately, we do the stent, and again, you may be concerned that at the time, that's free, that's cost, and that's follow-up. And if you look at cost, some of us were concerned by the amputation here. And I said, okay, it's fine, you have fixed what you really, for a period of 6 months, everything went very well. Since the stent is unchanged, if you look again with the ECG gate, the systole and diastole, you could see that this individual has basically no neonatal hyperplasia. It is interesting to do again a virtual histology in this individual, and you see that behind the spurts of the stent, there are still what people believe some limited particular here. What is fascinating is that if we do the calcogram now, because we have the scaffolding in the metal, everything is blue in a uniform way, because basically you have eliminated all these regions of high strain. And finally, if you look at the shear stress, that was the shear stress before the stent patient, it is now the shear stress, and I will not go into detail,